Hello students, I welcome you all in new classes. As we all are aware, whole world is facing the problem of COVID-19. But for the welfare of students, our school has started virtual classes and I welcome you all in the first virtual class of subject Maths. And our class, we will start with the topic real numbers. So students, we are going to recapitulate our knowledge with the real numbers. First of all, we always use the numbers, counting numbers like 1, 2, 3 and so on. These numbers are known as natural numbers. Natural numbers, these are also written by N, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So natural numbers are counting numbers 1, 2, 3. Here the smallest natural number is 1 and we can't define greatest natural number. If I am having rupees 100 and I spend all the money, I am left with nothing. Nothing means 0. So if I add 0 to the pocket of natural numbers, then we get whole numbers. Whole numbers written by W, 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Again, the smallest whole number is 0 and we cannot define greatest whole number. One more thing, here we observe all natural numbers are whole numbers. But students, if we are having rupees 50 and we require rupees 70, then we are having lack of rupees 20, that means minus. So if I add minus of natural numbers, means negative of natural numbers, to the pocket of whole numbers, then we get the new numbers. These are known as integers. These are known as integers, written by I. So integers are minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, and again the natural numbers. So here we observe, I can't define smallest integer. I can't define greatest integer, but I can define greatest negative integer. Greatest negative integer is minus 1. So now we can express it on number line also. First of all, here we are having our number line, then 0 in the middle, that is dividing negative and positive natural numbers. These are integers. One, two, three. Clearly we can see here, every natural number is a whole number. And every whole number is an integer. So I can't define smallest negative number, I can't define greatest integer, but I can define greatest negative integer. After that, we are coming to the word fraction. Fraction, I think you all are aware about the fraction. Fraction. Here I just write two fractions, 1 by 2, 1 by 3. If I change this fraction into decimal form, I get 1 by 2 is equal to 0.5, because as I divide one by two, I get the remainder 0. Remainder 0 means the fraction ends and the decimal is terminating. If r is 0, then it is terminating decimal form. Terminating decimal form. But if I change 1 by 3 into decimal form, then 3 threes are 9, remainder is 1. I again divide, 3 threes are 9, remainder is 1. Here, I am not getting remainder 0. And one more thing, in each case, I am getting the remainder 1. And here, 3 is also repeating. Therefore, it is known as non-terminating. Non-terminating decimal form. When we get this? When remainder is not equal to 0. So it means when r is not equal to 0, then it is non-terminating decimal form. And when r is equal to 0, it is terminating decimal form. So students, I hope you enjoyed the class. You are able to understand. We will carry the same topic of real numbers in the next virtual class. Here is one assignment for you. Is every whole number is an integer? Change 1 by 7 into decimal form. What is the greatest negative integer? And change 1 by 16 into decimal form. If any query, then you please do the email to this ID. Thank you.